Hello guys, this is Suprateem and I am back with another series, and in this series we will discuss about the different interview question. Now this will be maybe a 3 or 4 parts video. In each part we will discuss about few question about the Python language which generally asked by the interviewer in the interview. So without any further delay, let's get started and welcome to Total Technology. So here are the questions interview may asked. What are the key features of Python? If it makes for an introductory language to programming, Python must mean something. These are its qualities. It is first interpreted language and then dynamically typed, and it is object oriented, concise and simple, free, and has a large community. Now you see, Python has a very large community and its library is huge and contributed by everyone. It is a free one, is concise and simple, just like an English language. You just type it, it interpreted language. So these are the main key features of Python language. Now our second question is, differentiate between deep and shallow copy. Now a deep copies an object into a deep copy copies an object into another. This means that if you make a change to a copy of an object, it won't affect the original object. In Python we use the function deep copy for this, and we import the module copy. We use it like import copy, then say suppose b is equal to copy dot deep copy a. It is like it in a bag, you have Mandy, Ron, Jacob bag, and it will copy to the bag too. The bag one remain will same, and it will refer b as bag 2. Now a shallow copy, however, copies the object reference to another. So if we make a change in the copy, it will affect the original copy. For this we have the function copy. Usually copy, if you use normal copy, it will be a shallow copy. Okay, now what is the differentiate between list and tuple? The major difference is that a list is a mutable, but a tuple is immutable. As for example, if your list is, now one thing keep in mind, the list is denoted in third bracket and tuple is first bracket. So my list 133, if I access my list 1, it will give, if I say my list 1 is equal to 2, then it will change the value of 3 to 2. And if we try to do that same in tuple, it will give us an error. See, my tuple 1 type tuple object does not support item assignment. So this is the main differentiate between list and tuple. Now explain the ternary operator in Python. Unlike C++, we don't have a ternary in Python, but we have this colon. On true if expression, else on false means if else the expression is true, the statement under on true is executed, else that under on false is executed. Below is how you would use it. Say suppose you have two variable a, b, and the value of these two variable are 2 and 3. So minimum is another variable, and you assign it like a if a greater than b, else b. So if a less than b, here it is true, So minimum is equal to here is equal to a, so 2. Similarly, print high if a less than b, else print by. So it will print high. Now next question is, our next question is, how is multithreading achieved in Python? A thread is a lightweight process and multithreading allows us to execute multiple threads at once. As you know, Python is a multi-threaded language. It has a multi-threading package. The global interpreter log GIL ensures that a single thread executes at a time. A thread holds the GIL and does a little work before passing it on the next thread. This makes for an illusion of parallel execution, but in reality it is just threaded taking turns at the CPU. Of course, all the passing around adds overhead to the execution. So now we will move to our next question. Explain inheritance in Python. Now you have heard inheritance about in different languages like Java and other. Python is also having that, and you can explain it like, when one class inherits from another, it is said to be child derived or subclass inheriting from the parent or base or superclass. It inherits gains all members, attributes and methods. Inheritance lets us reuse the code and also make it easier to create and maintain application. Python supports the following kind of inheritance. Single inheritance means a class inherits from a single base class. Multiple inheritance, a class inherits from multiple base classes. Then multi-level inheritance, a class inherits from a base class which in turn inherits from another base class. Hierarchical inheritance, multiple classes inherit from a single base class. Hybrid inheritance, hybrid inheritance is a combination of two or more type of inheritance. Now, what is flux? Python flux, as we have previously discussed, is a web microframe for Python. It is based on the Wrexut Zynga 2 and Good Intention BSD license. Two of its dependencies are Wrexut and Zynga 2. This means it has around no dependencies on external libraries. Due to this, we can call it a light framework. A session uses a signed cookie to allow the user to look at and modify session contents. It will remember information from one request to another. However, to modify a session, the user must have a secret key, flux.secret_key. So next is, how is memory managed in Python? Python has a private heap space to hold all objects and data structures. Being programmers, we cannot access it. It is the interpreter that manages. But with the core API, we can access some tools. The Python memory manager controls the allocation. Additionally, an inbuilt garbage collector recycles all unused memory so it can make it available to the heap space. Next is, explain help and directory function in Python. The help function displays a documentation string and help for its argument. Import copy, then help copy.copy. Help on function copy in module copy, copy x. Shallow copy operates an arbitrary Python project. See the modules doc string for more info. The directory function display all the members of an object any kind. Directory copy dot copy. As for example, whenever you exit Python, is all memory deallocated? The answer here is no. The modules with circular reference to other object or to object reference from global namespaces aren't always freed on exiting Python. Plus, it is impossible to deallocate portion of memory reserved by the C library. Then what is monkey patching? Dynamically modifying a class or module at a runtime is monkey patching. Say suppose class A, and then we define it as define function self print hi, define monkey self print hi monkey. Now if we call m dot a dot function is equal to monkey, then a is equal to m a is equal to function, so it will print hi monkey. Now what is a dictionary in Python? A Python dictionary is something I have never seen in other languages like C++ or Java programming. It holds key value pairs. Suppose this is our dictionary roots. It's 25 holds value 5, 16 holds 4, 9 holds 3, 4 holds 2, 1 holds 1. If we type roots class, it will show us that it is a type dictionary type. If we type roots 9, the dictionary is mutable and we can also use as a comprehension to create it. Say suppose root x into 2, x for in range of 5 to 0. Then it will do like this 25, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 like this. Again, so next question is, what do you mean by args and kw args? In cases we don't know how many arguments will be passed to a function, like when we want to pass a list of tuple of values, we use args. Say suppose define function as args for I in args print I function 32147. It will now print 32147. Now kw args takes keyword argument when we don't know how many there will be. Define function kw args, then for I in kw args print I kw args I function a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, c is equal to 7. So it will print a dot 1, b dot 2, c dot 7. The words args and kw args are a convention and we can use anything in their place. Any double yet in basic Python interview question and answer facer, please ask this in our comments. Thank you and hope you guys like our today's session. We will be back with more interesting question and answers videos to you. Stay tuned. Bye bye. Take care.